Second down, Prescott quick throw again. Land in stride. Room to run. He's down inside the 20. Makes a move.
We interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be football and football and football and football. And did I mention football? Well, guess what? Branta Claus is coming to town because it is time for the 2024 Fantasy Football Draft. Welcome back. I'm your holly jolly commissioner, Brant, and I'm here to welcome you back for another rip-roaring season of fantasy football. It's time to pick up where we left off with the blood feuds, temporary alliances, and everything that comes with the lifestyle we've chosen as fantasy football team managers. But to look forward, we need to look back at what happened last season. Let's analyze the contenders and teams who are vying for this year's crown. And let's start from the top with Queen Kelly herself, our fantasy football champion. Round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. There was no sophomore slump for Kelly. She took the crown in her second year and popped that top shelf bubbly. You know, it's hard to go back to the cheap stuff after you've sipped the finest. But guess what, Kelly? When you're the champion, it's nice to be on top, but I will mention that you got 13 thirsty boys chasing after you. Metaphorically, of course. No offense, Travis. Wild horses. Duality of life. As we know, there are highs and lows, left and right, white and black, Kelly and Colin. The turd really fell in the punch bowl last year for Colin, but he only finished 14th out of 14 teams, so it's all good. But he has more to fight for this season. So Colin, pull yourself up by the bootstraps and let's get it done. You're newly engaged. Do it for Lindsay at least. I mean, come on, show some heart, brother. Brandon finished last season in the finest suite of the Heartbreak Hotel in one of the craziest fantasy football championship finishes I've ever seen, losing by less than a point. Some say he was trying to do an impression of his favorite team, the Eagles, in Super Bowl 57, but those reports are not confirmed. Now this man has the skills, so can he elevate to the penthouse this season? I don't know. You tell me. Let me know, Brandon. Let me know. Papa, can you hear me? Papa, can you see me?
Yep.
Well, if you can, because you just said you could, then I'm going to have to ask you to take a step back, because you keep beating me every season that we've played together in this fantasy football league, and you're embarrassing me in front of all my friends. But you have a bad back, so it's all good, and I'm going to beat you this year, okay? Just remember that. File that one away. You know, Frank also humbled Travis last season. Having your wife and father thump you into submission must give you a serving of humble pie. But you know what? At the dinner table, ask your wife for some fantasy football advice and you actually might make the playoffs this year. Probably not. El Chapo, a.k.a. Brett Chapman. You kind of pulled a disappointing season last year. You know, you were fantasy football champ 2 years ago. I mean, sure, you made the playoffs, but after winning it all, kind of fell short of expectations. But you know what? My Boomer Sooner boy, I believe in you. I believe in you. Corey rhymes with glory. I'm not going to lie. This guy had a fantastic rookie year last year for joining our league. And as CEO of the Dak Prescott Fan Club, this man is looking to feast on the prime rib of glory rather than choke. And that, my friends, is a metaphor. James is trying to rank up from Colonel to the General this season, but does he have enough herbs and spices up his sleeve to achieve this feat? I believe so, because that shit is delicious. And also, bring back the double down. I know you have that level of sway. please bring back the double down. Please. From halfway across the world, Mazar is trying to put together back-to-back over 500 seasons for his first time in his 12 illustrious years in this league. And can he do it? I don't know, but all I know is that he's going to put together the best auto draft you have ever seen. The man wrote the book on it. So best of luck with your auto draft tonight, and I hope the computer chooses the best picks for you. Just kidding, buddy. Love you. Hope all is well with you, sir. Andrew Holder, the fearless coach of the Rusty Trombones. You look to have a bounce back season after a really rough one last year. Play some sweeter tunes. Just need to purse your lips and blow extra hard this year if you're going to look to achieve what you're normally used to. Guess what? I believe in you, bud. Known you since fifth grade. You got it in you. And how about the DIY guy himself? Mr. Jordan Giardini. Took me 5 takes to say that name correctly. You know, the man can put on baseboards, he can lay concrete, he can bake delicious loaves of sourdough bread. But can you craft together a great fantasy football team? That remains to be seen within the confines of this league. So prove me wrong. Get it done right. Every dog has his day, and I check the calendar. And Uncle Baby Blair Downer is due for his day eventually. Now, can the man put together a team worthy to get the Bible bonkers going? Well, that remains to be seen. But guess what, my friend? You got it in you. Search very deep inside, like really deep. Really deep. Get in there. You'll find it. And last but not least, me. For missing the fantasy football playoffs last year, I punished myself in unspeakable ways. But the megastar always rebounds and always rises. Yeah! So by the end of this season, everybody's gonna be saying Brant Morrell. Yeah! 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 Water. What? Beer. Beer. Yeah, beer's better. Beer's better. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Nothing brings people together like fantasy football, forging our blades in the fire against each other. Our forefathers teabagged those damn Brits so we could have the right to play fantasy football with each other. From Purple Mountain Majesties, my country tis of thee, to your living room, it's time. And in the words of the greatest American to ever live, John Cena, never give up. Never give up. Have a great fantasy football draft this season, ladies and gentlemen. Go on, get it.
And the only thing else I got to say is, how about them Cowboys? Yeah!